Hi friends, I'm here in Colombo, Sri Lanka at the Gull Face Hotel for a new episode of 7 Days in Paradise.
In Sri Lanka, you can see the expression of the four religions: Buddhism, Hinduism, Islam, and Christianism.
The best way to travel around Sri Lanka, especially if you want to see a lot of things in a few days, is to get the service of a driver. I really recommend the services of my friend Janaka. He's an amazing driver. He shows everything, and you have his contact info down here, or you can also contact me.
Welcome to Sri Lanka, everybody.
Here we are at the Elephant Orphanage. It's an amazing landscape with a lot of elephants. You have baby elephants and everything, and they are free here in this beautiful paradise. In the center of the city of Kandy, this beautiful city with a colonial touch, we have this artificial lake that is part of or one of the landmarks of the city. And here they also have the most important Buddhist temple in Sri Lanka, that is the temple of the tooth of Buddha, the tooth that the Indian princess brought here to Sri Lanka. You can actually take pictures and you can do videos also, but you cannot give your back to the Buddha as a respect, and you have to wear long pants or something, so you respect the Buddhism and respect the Buddha. And this is the Buddha Tooth Center temple.
In the city of Kandy, you cannot miss the Royal Botanical Garden of Pirandinea.
Now we are leaving the city of Kandy and we are on the way to
Nuera Elia
with Fernando Janaka. Here our driver, he's amazing and he's showing us the whole place, and we are gonna take about 2 hours to get there, but in the way we're gonna stop in the
tea factory.
It's tea time!
Hey, orange peco meaning adult big leaves. This one is OP, orange peco. This is peco. This is green tea. Okay? FBOP, BOP, BOPF, very strong tea you can use with milk and sugar. Last one is dust. You can see local market, supermarket, but it is not quality, and especially small tea bags. But it is not quality, not good. These all are black tea. Black tea and green tea come this tea plant. Okay?
One of the things that you cannot miss when you visit Sri Lanka is to visit a tea plantation. We are in one of them. It's in the area of Norawa Eliwa. This area is also known as Little England because the British came here and planted tea, and they did a huge plantation, and nowadays the Sri Lankan tea is known all over the world. One of the coolest hotels in the whole Sri Lanka is this one we have in the back. Is the Heritage Tea Factory Hotel. It's an old tea factory that they remodel it and make a hotel, a unique hotel that you should come visit. If you cannot afford it, at least come and have some tea in it, because it's a beautiful place.
On the way to the City of Gems.
Good morning, Ratnapura! City of Gems! La ciudad de las gemas!
In the city of Ratnapura, the city of gems, we are gonna go down into a mine. Follow me and I will show you how they find the world famous Sri Lanka Ceylon Sapphire. Here we are, crawling down to find where they are digging right now. There's not a lot of air oxygen, but It's an amazing experience.
We arrived to the end of the mine. We scroll down for about 50 meters. It's very small, very tiny. You can find all these woods that is cork and all this that is gonna prevent the water to get in instead. But anyways, we have a lot of water here. There's some people working. What they're doing is like they're finding this type of earth, and in this earth we're gonna find the sapphires, the famous sapphire from Ceylon or from Sri Lanka.
After the walls of gravel, we are gonna come here to wash it, and we are gonna start moving it in order to the big stones to stay down.
El Zafiro Royal Blue.
Nicole Stevie!
We are leaving the city of Ratnapura and we are heading to Mirisa. I'm here with Super Janaka. We are gonna go to Mirisa to go to the beach and also to go
whale watching.
We just got to Mirisa at the south of Sri Lanka. It's a paradise for surfers and for people that want to spend some days in the beach.
Good morning, Mirisa. Whale watching paradise.
In the south of Sri Lanka, you can find the fortified city of Galle, a beautiful city with Portuguese, Dutch, British, and Indian influences.
And I'm here in Mitiagora at the south of Sri Lanka. We are gonna go visit a moonstone mine where we can find the blue shine moonstone.
Wow. Hello.
On our way back to Colombo, we stopped at Ventota and Veraguala, known for its beautiful and desert beaches.
We are getting to Veraguala Market. This is the market. It's really busy. It's one of the busiest days of the week. It's Saturday. And here they are going to be trading hundreds of stones, sapphires, moonstones, all type of stones.
This is all from Sri Lanka and this chapter of 7 Days in Paradise.
Nicole Stevie!